Well, we've changed sexes again now to feature the women's single Sculls. It's a quarter final where we'll be looking to Emma Twigg of New Zealand and Kim Crow of Australia, I think. Nice to see in lane one here, representing Iran. Lane two, Gabriela Mosquera Benitez from Paraguay. Emma Twigg is from New Zealand. Kim Crow, definitely from Australia. Marie-Louise Dräger from Germany. And finally in lane six, Deborah Oakley Gonzalez of Mexico.
Iran, Paraguay, New Zealand.
These really are always very
Australia,
nervous moments for the competitors.
Germany, Mexico.
Mexico,
attention.
He says. Can Mexico win the race? Doubtful, as I say, you would expect that your first two slots would be filled by Australia and New Zealand. Twig away nicely for the Kiwis here. Clear water already established with the Iranian lagging in sixth place in lane one.
Women's.
Kim Crow, the Australian, well over 6 feet tall. Dräger, the German, in the baseball cap. Twig for New Zealand. The crowd have absolutely loved these events. The women's single Sculls, I think, in particular, have caught the imagination. To establish a lead over the first 500 metres, of course. Australia and New Zealand are indeed both going well as expected. So the race going very much according to plan. And we look at the time for Kim Crow as she comes in first. One of the few people here who is competing in two events. She's in the doubles as well. 149.1 for her. Twig just a second down, Dräger for Germany in third, Oakley Gonzalez of Mexico in fourth, and Mosquera Benitez of Paraguay in fifth. Such a tough sport, tough on the knees as well, as Kim Crow shows. All about coordination. Right on the day, it's a very pleasing sport in which to participate. You get a great deal of satisfaction out of winning such an individual event as this. We'll have women's double Sculls featured in these Olympic Games later as well, of course. Not an easy decision for Crow to decide to take part in both. Was her decision. Well, she's 26 years of age now, 6 feet 2 inches tall. She was 10th in the pair in Beijing 4 years ago. She's a writer by occupation, and her dad Max played Aussie rules for those famous clubs Essendon and St Kilda. So he's passed on the sporting genes for Kim Crow. Also in your shot there, Emma Twigg, the 25-year-old New Zealander from Hawke's Bay, ninth in Beijing. So come on, Emma. She's pushing Crow, but Crow is first at the 1,000-metre mark. That's halfway through this race, 2,000 metres being the length of the course here at Eton Dorney. The German in third at the moment is Marie-Louise Dreger, 31 years of age. She's in the army, based in Rostock. Coming in four is the Mexican now, Deborah Oakley Gonzalez, 31 years of age. Very tall for a Mexican, 6 feet 1 inches. Still not as tall as this girl, Crow. Dedicated to her sport, Kim Crow. She could end up as a double gold medalist in these Games of London 2012. Terrifically physical sport. I don't think people always appreciate that because they make it look so easy. That's if they've got good rhythm, as Emma Twigg has at the moment, coached by Richard Tonks. Trains at Karapiro, a couple of hours out of Auckland. She has a silver medal from World Cup to her CV, does Emma Twigg, and she from this angle looks to be closing fractionally on Kim Crow. Just a year between them. Looking good for an Australia-New Zealand 1-2. German may still have something to say about that. Marie-Louise Dreger, 31 years of age. But it's looking pretty easy for Crow. She's first at the three-quarter mark race, the point of the race. Twigg is second. And that's just the way we expected it to turn out. 5:36.4 Crow, 3.4 seconds up on Twigg. Dreger way, way back in third. What that means is that the Australian and the New Zealander can take it relatively easy over the closing phases of the race. Place in the semi-final established, and barring any accidents, absolutely certain for the pair of them. Competition intensifies, of course, as we move towards medal days. Still plenty of competition and fierce competition to be witnessed by these fans here at Eton Dorney, and how they've loved every single second of it. 3 or 4 hours of rowing on the first, about 5 hours of rowing on the first day, 3 on the second day, just a couple of hours yesterday, but today's a lengthy programme again. There will be 4 quarterfinals in this event. But nice for Crow and for Twigg to make their presence known in the first of the day. They'll enjoy their coffee a little later on, that's for sure. Here she comes then, Kim Crow, 26 years of age, and New Zealand in the second position at the moment. They'll be roaring back there in Hawke's Bay. And even a glass of their famous white wine to celebrate, and a Twigg's progression into the semi-final. Australia 1, New Zealand 2. And that's the way it's been from the very off. And their own individual coaches, and all that training pays off. Kim Crow comes in first, Emma Twigg comes in second. And trailing back in third, quite a long way back in third, Marie-Louise Dreger. A hint of a smile from Crow. A fine effort from her. And here is Dreger now touching to get that third spot, all important. But there will be no medals for the other three competitors in that particular race. Sulmaza Abbasiazad of Iran, Deborah Oakley Gonzalez of Mexico, who comes in now in fourth, and Gabriela Mosquera Benitez of Paraguay, she's just finishing. And here is the one competitor left out on the lake, completing her race, the 28-year-old Iranian coached by the Hills, Dave and Mike. If he finishes now, that's a good effort to get home. There's the winner, 26-year-old Kim Crow, almost 6 feet, 2 inches over. It went to plan, it went to form. 7:34.29, Crow's time. And that's the first quarter final of the day in the women's single sculls. We'll shortly have the second. In fact, why don't we do that right now? And this is the start list to Camila Vargas Palomo of El Salvador, Sanita Puspure of Ireland. And this is Vargas Palomo, known as Nina. 25-year-old who also loves skating and studies architecture. Sanita Puspure from Ireland. In the red spotted headband, Frida Svensson of Sweden. Then we will find Miroslava Napkova of Czech Republic, third in the Olympic Games last time round. Ginevra Stone, United States, in lane 5.
Ireland.
And completing the lineup, Sweden, from Cuba.
Czech Republic, United States of America, Cuba. Attention.
Cuba's done well today. Seen some good efforts from them. Their training program clearly paying off. The green light is on. That means the race is underway. You'd expect Napkova, the Czech Republic girl in lane 4, to be right in there at the finish. The current world champion. To look at times in this women's single sculls. We've not had any new Olympic records today. Maybe the conditions are not quite as conducive as they have been on the previous 3 days for that. It would appear that the three central lanes are the best favoured ones here now, with the score of Ireland, the Svensson of Sweden and Napkova of Czech Republic to the fore. Being left behind just a little bit is Palomo of El Salvador in lane 1. The lead, early lead, is taken by Sanita Puspure, the 30-year-old Irish girl who says she loves knitting. Married to Latvian Kaspers. She's the girl in green. The 4 of your picture is Miroslava Napkova from Czech Republic. She's 31 now in her third Olympics. She's had 2 World Cup victories, 1 World Championship success as well. Napkova, she's the clear favourite for this race. Watch out for the yellow boat to be first to the finishing line at the end. But a good effort from the Irish, Sanita Puspore, she's 30. Sweden just in second at the moment. With Frida Svensson, known as Bumblebee. And she acquired that nickname when she was a youngster. And they said she was so small, and yet she was so fast in the boat. Bumblebee. A former world champion as well, Svensson. So Svensson and Napkova, no surprise that they are to the fore of this race. Four shows on the boat. You can look across lanes, it's not always obvious which lane somebody is occupying. Especially when the boats are all together. But there's clear water now between Napkova and the rest of the field. She leads the way from Svensson and Puspure. In there in lane 3 from the Falkenberg Club. Czech Republic has always had strong competitors in sport. So a good effort earlier today from one of the Czech rowing team. They seem to be getting stronger in that particular sport. Certainly here, the portents are good for Miroslava Napkova. As you would expect of a world champion, she's out in front. It is Sweden in second place, as expected again from Frida Svensson. And then the United States representative, Ginevra Stone, has edged ahead of Sunita Pascua. Stone, who is 27, 6 feet inches tall, and enjoys sailing as well, and her parents were both world-class rowers. Her mum took part in the 1976 Olympic Games. Her dad would have taken part in Russia, but the United States pulled out of that particular event in Moscow. There's been so much strain placed on the back muscles in this event, and on the knees in particular. The nose move up and down in that mechanical seat. She continues to impress in first place, does Napkova. 31, still a pretty good age to be competing. She's kept herself extremely fit. Disciplined training up first thing in the morning, out on the river, then back again sometimes later in the afternoon. They really do put their bodies through some amazing exertion. The current world champion Miroslava Napkova is having few problems in negotiating her way through to the semi-final. You get an idea of the size of the crowd from that shot here. The vantage points just beyond the towpath. The rhythm is good, the time is good at 1500 metres. So Napkova almost leisurely as she goes through in 5:37.3. Svensson for Sweden goes in second, and Stone of the United States of America. In third, they'll be cheering her back home. Fourth was Pascua of Ireland, and fifth the Cuban Cobas. I don't think we're going to get another Cuban triumph here today. We've had a couple. Way back in sixth is Palomo of El Salvador. Sorry, I'm not able to report anything more promising for those people watching in that country in Central America. But certainly for the people of the Czech Republic, this is looking very good indeed. Miroslava Napkova just sending out a message to the rest of the field that she's come here to win. And win she may well do. She's certainly going to win today. Whether she wins the final as well remains to be seen, of course. And what terrific finals we're going to have here at Eton Dorney. The excitement building as the week progresses. This is the fourth day of competition. And she is miles in front. I know that's a phrase that's incorrect, of course. She's certainly metres in front. The phrase miles in front expresses the distance that she's established between those two grandstands and the rest of the rowers out here. But there will be a battle for second place, maybe, between Frida Svensson of Sweden and Ginevra Stone of the United States of America. It's going to be a victory for Czech Republic. Comfortably cruising over the line. Here she finishes now. Excellent effort, Miroslava Napkova. She'll be very pleased with that. And it is Stone who has nicked the second place. Very good effort from Ginevra Stone to take second ahead of Frida Svensson. So Ireland just missing the cuts because the first three go through to the semi-finals. And that was Napkova, Stone and Svensson in that order. Our winner here gives a wave to the fans. And can relax now. And just coming in last on the far side, Paloma. So world championship performance here from Miroslava Napkova. And She was never in any trouble. As soon as the bell sounded, as soon as the green light went on, Napkova took charge of the race. Commanding performance then from the reigning world champion, and Napkova in 7:35.35 was in comfortably ahead of the valiant Ginevra Stone. The third of these quarterfinals features from Thailand, Putaraksa Negre Rodenburg. Here she is, 5 feet 5 inches tall, very much the smallest of the competitors, known as Pack. Thankfully, she's in the Navy. And in the yellow is Donata Vistatate of Lithuania from China Xuzhang, Shangshiu Yuan. Representing Russia, Shulia Levina. From Zimbabwe, Machine Thornycroft.
Thailand,
from Argentina,
Lithuania, Asia,
Palermo,
China, Russia, Zimbabwe, Argentina.
They're all on their marks.
Attention.
The Argentinian awaited the announcement of her country. And prepares to be away, and they are away first time. Green light on. Favourite here may well be the Chinese girl, the 36-year-old from Beijing Sports Institute, Jiangxiu Yuan, who won the first two World Cup regattas this year. And she has made a good start over there in lane three. You can't mistake the Russians here, can you, in that distinctive red and white. And we have 39-year-old Julia Levina representing that country, a linguist from Krasnodar University. But China leads immediately. Racing start from Jiangxiu Yuan. An excellent competitor who shows great style. Never looks hurried, never looks in any trouble at all. Eats up the water. Gliding through it at the moment, impressively. On her right, Donata Vistatate of Lithuania. In the yellow headband. He's a student at Rose at Kaunas. Good to see Lithuania prospering in this sport now. And she's acquitting herself very well in this race. In lane five from Zimbabwe there, Machine Thornycroft, who has the nickname of Maps for some strange reason and attends the Rhodes University in Grahamstown. But it's all eyes on China right now. Jiangxiu Yuan, 36, still enjoying her sport as much as ever. No thoughts of retirement for her. Russia have gone through in second place. I know Lithuania just ahead of Russia. An optical illusion there, I think. Thornycroft in fourth for Zimbabwe. She looks entirely at ease with her sport. An easy little row, just a nice little Tuesday afternoon, is it now? Yes, it is just an afternoon. 2,500 into the competition today. We've seen various disciplines. Quite a few more to go as well yet. A protracted program today compared to yesterday. So good value for money for the spectators who've turned out in force. Thankfully it's not raining, even though it's much cooler today. That's the 750-metre mark. Jack's stroke rate at a mere 28. Pushes away. Great power there. Bit of smoothness and a rhythm which is to behold. And it's hard to see her being troubled in this race, because she's established a superiority over the rest of the field. Coming through in second at the moment, there is Julia Levina, a 39-year-old Russian who's a linguist. And Lithuania are just about in third at the moment. Vista Tate is a student as well. All those hours on the local lakes coming to the fore now. All that practice put in paying off. Just Russia 2 and Lithuania 3 behind China. 3:44.8, the halfway mark timing. Zimbabwe in form. Machine Thornycroft. Argentina in fifth place at the moment, Lucia Palermo. His brother Diego was also an international rower. The back marker of the field is a girl called Pat. Putaraksa Nigri Rodenburg at time. 38 years of age now. Enjoying his sport and a break from duties in the Navy. At 28, Vista Tate at 31, Levina at 30 on that stroke weight chart. All the statistics adding to the knowledge of the sport, which features prominently at the Olympic Games and has done for so many, many years. Ever since it made its debut in 1900, though not for women until 1976. That's when the Olympics were first staged. Past the giant screen in the background, up towards the grandstands. China's Jiangxi Youyuan. Making it look ridiculously easy. I'm sure yet it is not easy. Vista Tate appears to be going quite nicely over on the far side as well. We'll get a better view in a second though. At the 1500 metres mark, it is China first, and it is still Russia second in lane four, with Lithuania in lane two third, but very little between those two. But a good lead for Zhang. Thornycroft just gone through that 1500 metre mark now, 13 seconds behind the leader. But over a considerable stretch of water. Coordination absolutely vital in the success ratio in this sport. Zhang just looks so much in control of herself and of the race. She will be formidable in the final one, thanks. And she'll face much sterner competition than today. And she's not there yet, of course. Cheering her home, the fans who've been, some of them have had their tickets for over a year. This is their big day, and this is the rowers' big day. And it is going to be China 1, Russia 2, and Lithuania 3. She can't afford to raise her arm and salute the fans just yet. But Jiangxi Youyuan has put in an impressive stint here to take first place from the Russian Julia Levina. In fact, Levina's putting in a great push, but the Chinese athlete will still be first across that finishing line. And the Lithuanian will be third, and that's a good effort from her as well. And applause all the way to the finish line, which the Chinese touches now, Russia now, and Lithuania now. China 1, Russia 2, Lithuania 3. A good row from Jiangxi Youyuan. 7:39.58. The 36-year-old clinches her place in the final. Minor placing just completed now with the final competitor Rodenberg in lane one. Just getting home. And I think we can see from this excellent illustration here just what a good rower Chang Shi Yuan is. He makes it look very rhythmical, very easy. Almost with something in reserve there. He strolled home. Look, he doesn't even look to be drawing breath now. An outstanding showing in 739.58, and China has a representative in the final, as do Russia and Lithuania.
And so the last then of our quarterfinals.
This will be the last of the quarterfinals. Six more ladies out there, including Korea's Kim Ye-ji. We've got Korea, Japan, Azerbaijan, Belarus, Denmark and Brazil represented. Here wearing the glasses is the Korean representative, Ye-ji Kim. We have an 18-year-old from Japan, very much learning her trade, Haruna Sakakibara. 26 years of age, Natalia Mustafaya. In lane four, the experienced Ekaterina Kasten, 40 years of age from Belarus, and she's won medals at every Olympic Games since 1992.
Denmark.
Well, the younger fee would be Eriksson from Denmark.
Attention.
And Kissia da Costa of Brazil complete the lineup. Well, you would expect Karsten to be first home in this race. She has a height advantage. She's 6 feet 1 inches tall. That's an inch taller than the Japanese Sakakibara. She's the blonde lady, the one I'm talking about, Ekaterina Kasten of Belarus, in lane four. She has the experience to deal with all of this, all the years of competition, so many Olympic Games, quite remarkable that she's featured in every one since 1992. She's not in the lead at the moment, though. That privilege goes to Fjord P. Eriksson of Denmark. He's reading novels. Young lady in lane five has the early advantage. There's been a good start as well over in lane one from the Korean Republic, Kim Ye-ji. 17 years of age, so 23 years the difference between lane one and lane four. Will it be youth or will it be experience today? Struggling a little bit. In lane two is Sakakibara. And also Kissia da Costa in lane six, the 30-year-old Brazilian. Enjoys contemporary dancing. Just trailing at the moment. To her advantage in lane five is Eriksson, growing a very popular sport in Denmark. Kasten from Belarus going equally well and maybe saving some of her energy. Certainly puffing and blowing a bit is Eriksson there, but each athlete deals with this race in a distinctive way. They have their own styles, they have they feel comfortable with. She's managed to hit the front ahead of Karsten. She will know that Ekaterina Karsten will probably put in a late spurt. So if she can stay with her, that's got to be Eriksson's tactic. Both stroke rating at 31. Lane 5 from lane 4. I think where we have the Azerbaijani Natalia Mustafayeva. Azerbaijan, one of the emerging nations. No clear water between these two. roars of encouragement from the banks. They've not yet reached the grandstand stage of the race. A really good effort being put in by Ericsson. Cheeks looking a little bit flushed maybe with all the effort. Going very smoothly is the 6'1" tall Carsten, though. He had a rib injury not too long ago, but returned with a win in Munich, which showed she was really up for this challenge to win Olympic gold again. She's twice retired and twice come back. And 7 of a second difference between Ericsson and Karsten. Mustafayeva, Azerbaijan in third, Kim of Korea fourth, Sakaki Bara of Japan in fifth, and Da Costa for Brazil completing the field in sixth. She too, the wrong side of 30 now, but still loving her rowing. It's the Brazilian Tissier Da Costa. Physically grueling pursuit.
These two.
Speaking of the word pursuit, Carsten is doing exactly that in pursuing Ericsson all the way. Right from the start, it's been these two out in front. And often that happens in races where two get away from the rest of the field and just cajole one another along. The only question would be at what point of the race Carsten might suddenly decide to try and go ahead, and I think this might just be that point. She knows when to make a move. So in the women's single sculls, all of a sudden, Ekaterina Carsten shows her class and just nudges ahead of Fjordby Eriksson, who's led all the way to this point. That just shows that Carsten has known what she's been doing, just waiting for her moment to cat and mouse like pursuit. She really is a legend, having competed and won a medal at every Olympics going back to 92, her sixth Olympic Games. In fact, she's just been edged back again now. Well done to Fjordby Eriksson. Still has the lead. Half a second ahead. Carsten's had to keep a pretty low profile all year because of that rib injury. Eriksson will be very high profile back in Denmark if she completes a victory here. On the towpath, keeping a good eye on proceedings. It's going to be interesting as to who the fans favour here. Will they go for the young lady pushing out at the front, or will they go for the veteran going for yet another medal? The loyalties perhaps split at the moment. The field was split a long time ago between these two and the rest. And it will be a question of who comes in third. But Eriksson is looking strong enough to take that first place. Carsten may well have to settle for second today. That will be good enough, of course, to get her through into the semi-final. It's a comfortable finish for the two of them, but it will be Fjordby Eriksson of Denmark. She can go away and lead one of her favourite novels. Look at the effort she's putting in here just to make sure she finishes. She looks to still have plenty left in her. Highly impressive. Carsten just glancing, will not be too worried, I don't think, to let her rival have the honours today. And there you can see the black line across, which signifies that they're coming to the end of the race. Terrific win. Fjordby Eriksson of Denmark. Coming in second is the Belarusian Carsten. A good win in 7:38. And coming in third is the Azerbaijani Mustafa Fayeva. Denmark, Belarus, Azerbaijan. And those are the three who go through to the semi-final. The other three go through into the battle, which is not for the medals. It must be hard work at the age of 40, but she still loves her rowing, clearly. So those were the four quarterfinals in the women's single sculls. We now move on to quarterfinal. That's the result of the last of the quarterfinals. Eriksson from Karsten, from Mustafa Eva.